Michael, thank you. We continue our team coverage now. KOCO's Katy Blakey is live in Blanchard. And Katy, you've talked to people in town and members of the family.
That's right, Wendell. I spoke with Jaymie's brother this afternoon before any of us learned of Jaymie's death. He told me then that he was very worried, that he was worried he may never see his sister again. And tonight, those fears were confirmed. We want to show you the Facebook page that has sparked so much of this story. So many people leaving their condolences on this Facebook page after learning of Jaymie's passing. Now, several people are writing of condolences for her children. Also, strangers sharing their prayers and words of comfort for her young boys. Many of them, though, are calling for justice. Now, people we spoke with here tonight in Blanchard say they were stunned to learn of her death.
Instant chills. I almost, you know, wanted to cry, but it's just, it's sad to hear that. Really, really, really sad.
We tried reaching out to some of Jaymie's family, but they did not want to talk to us tonight. Jaymie's husband has hired an attorney. Tonight, he released this statement. He, Justin rather, is devastated and with his family right now. And as we know, Blanchard is a small community, a tight-knit community. So news of Jaymie's disappearance has been tough on this area. And as we spoke to people tonight, they just cannot believe that her body was found. And now they want answers. We are live tonight in Blanchard. Katy Blakey, KOCO, Eyewitness News 5.